Good evening, everyone. Okay, we are going to start our ceremony. Everyone that are like, welcome our graduates. The first year we've auditorium, we have out. Thank you, everyone. We're going to start off with a few words to Dr. Chuck Darling, who is Lakeland State College president.
Good evening. They forgot that box I'm supposed to stand on so you can see me above the monitor. Well, we'll just have to make do. Honored guests, graduates, students, faculty, staff, and friends, on behalf of the faculty and staff at Lake Region State College, I'd like to welcome you to the Adult Learning Center's 2018 commencement ceremony. Wow, what a turnout. Like April said, this is the first time we've had to move this because it was big. Thrilled to see what support graduates have, the family and came to celebrate with. They complete their first phase of their education and hopefully are looking at either going on to a next phase or workforce. So I had somebody say, you've got commencement. What's that? Anybody know? I thought I knew what. According to Webster, completing this. Need to, before you leave, look aside, thank those people who supported you, did homework, studied, passed, completed your. Welcome to Lake.
I would first like to start by thanking everyone for our graduates. I also want to express appreciation to staff is teacher appreciation. Without them, this night would not be possible. So please stand Bridget Hanlon, Connie Ripliner. Our staff commitment to our students the prized possession hold at our. Thank you to Lake Region State College's staff here today for all the support services to help our students. There is no I on our team, and without the team we have in place at Lake Region College, we would not be where we are today. Every student that has a team. There are no 2 days the same. Watching the students work so hard is so amazing and rewarding. On behalf of my entire staff of the Devil's Lake Adult Learning Center, as our motto states, I realize that everyone has very busy, yet you still may to come. It is that support that has made this day possible for all the graduates. They each have a very different. Many have had to overcome various barriers in order to accomplish this. Even with this detour, you have arrived at this destination point in your journey. The one thing that all these graduates do have in common is that a new doorway has opened to their future. receiving their GED will now allow them to take the next. For some of you, this is where your learning trip ends. And for others, this is simply a hurdle you have cleared on the way to the next. For some, it is college. Others, a promotion at a current job. And for a few, it is a sense of accomplishment, something they have wanted to pursue for many years, but never did until now. Working in adult education is more rewarding than I ever thought it could be. Every day, I have the privilege to meet students who are taking a huge step toward improving their lives. They are motivated by their families, children, or simply that desire for a better life. Their persistence and dedication is both very admirable. This is an extremely special day for every graduate in this school. I'm happy to see many of them in attendance tonight. The Devil's Lake Adult Learning Center has 41 students that have completed their GED this year so far, and we have 30 of them here tonight with us. Tonight, we are honored to have a local legislator in attendance. I would like to give him a chance to say a few words. Senator Dave Elkins.
I was hoping this would help because I was kind of judging who was taller. Congratulations. You know, one person, when I first came in, I said congratulations. She looked at me. She had no idea I was. But some of you I did get to talk to just a little bit. I found that to all, everyone has some one person already in college while working on her and helped get the stage today. So kudos. I don't know. So it's, or does it? Short that I would have to be that it is possible for you to make a difference in your own life, right? I can't tell you how proud that everybody sitting around you feel, how proud that somebody like me, first GED graduation, right? Got invited senator. Still am, and I've been 3 years because the job you've done to get this certificate is so special. Work so hard. You do it because you want it. Not because somebody's pushing you, not because you have parents getting you out of bed. Hurry up, got to get to school. You're doing it for you on your own. And I think that's so good and super. And I wish that effort. Now, onward and upward. Go forth, do good. Tell my wife.
The legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Achilles and his gifts, and Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fist. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list. But she said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss. Just something I can turn to, somebody I can kiss. I want something just like this. Somebody? Hello? Later. Help. Now, somebody please do
help!
Got it.
The wisest person I ever met in my life, a third grade dropout. Wisest and dropout in the same sentence is rather oxymoronic, like jumbo shrimp.
Mm-hmm.
Like Fun Run, ain't nothing fun about it. Like Microsoft Word, y'all don't hear me. I used to say like country music, but I've lived in Texas so long, I love country music now. I back down. I fish. I have cowboy boots. Cowboy, y'all. I'm a black neck redneck. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? No longer oxymoronic for me to say music, and it's not oxymoronic for me to say third grade and dropout. That third grade dropout, the wisest person I ever met in my life, who taught me to combine knowledge and wisdom to make an impact, was my father, a simple cook. Wisest man I ever met in my life. The simple cook left school in the third grade to help out on the family farm, but just because he left school doesn't mean his education stopped. Mark Twain once said, I've never allowed my schooling to get in the way of my education. My father taught himself how to read, taught himself how to write, decided in the midst of Jim Crowism, as America was breathing the last gasp of the Civil War, my father decided he was gonna stand and be a man. Not a black man, not a brown man, not a white man, but a man. He literally challenged himself to be the best that he could all the days of his life. I have 4 degrees. My brother is a judge. We're not the smartest ones in our family. It's a third grade dropout daddy. A third grade dropout daddy who was quoting Michelangelo, saying to us, boys, I won't have a... I want to share 2 things with you. Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. Therefore, excellence ought to be a habit, not an act. Don't ever forget that. I know you're tough, but always remember. Always. Don't ever forget that. Never embarrass mama.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy. If daddy ain't happy, don't nobody care. But, you know, I'm trying to tell you. Next lesson. Lesson from a cook over there in the galley. Son, Make sure your servant's towel is bigger than your ego. Ego is the anesthesia that deadens the pain of stupidity. Y'all might have a relative in mind you want to send that to. Let me say it again. Ego is the anesthesia that deadens the pain of stupidity. Pride is the burden of a foolish person. John Wooden coached basketball at UCLA for a living, but his calling was to impact people. And with all those national championships, guess what he was found doing in the middle of the week? Going into the cupboard, grabbing a broom, and sweeping his own gym floor. You want to make an impact? Find your broom. Every day of your life, you find your broom. You grow your influence that way. That way you're attracting people so that you can impact them. Final lesson. Son, if you're gonna do a job, do it right. I've always been told how average I can be. Always been criticized about being average. But I wanna tell you something. I stand here before you, before all of these people, not listening to those words, but telling myself every single day to shoot for the stars, to be the best that I can be. Good enough isn't good enough if it can be better. And better isn't good enough if it can be best. Let me close with a very personal story that I think will bring all this into focus. Wisdom will come to you in the unlikeliest of sources, a lot of times through failure. When you hit rock bottom, remember this. While you're struggling, rock bottom can also be a great foundation on which to build, on which to grow. I'm not worried that you'll be successful. I'm worried that you won't fail from time to time. The person that gets up off the canvas and keeps growing, that's the person that will continue to grow their influence. Back in the 70s, to help me make this point, let me introduce you. I met the finest woman I'd ever met in my life. Back in my day, we'd have called her a brick house. This woman was the finest woman I'd ever seen in my life. One little problem. Back then, ladies didn't like big old linemen. The blind side hadn't come out yet. They like quarterbacks and running backs. We're at this dance, and I find out her name is Trina Williams from Lompoc, California. And we were all dancing, and we're just excited. And I decide in the middle of dancing her that I would ask her for her phone number. Trina was the only woman in college who gave me her real telephone number. The next day, we walked to Baskin and Robbins Ice Cream Parlor. My friends couldn't believe it. This has been 40 years ago, and my friends still can't believe it. We go on a second date, and a third date, and a fourth date. We drive from Pico to Vallejo so that she can meet my parents. My father meets her. My daddy, my hero, he meets her, pulls me to the side and says, "Is she psycho?" But anyway, we go together for a year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. By now, Trina's a senior in college. I'm still a freshman, but I'm working some things out. I'm so glad I graduated in four terms. Nixon, Ford, Carter, Reagan. So now it's time to propose. So I talk to her girlfriend in California, 70s, so it has to be outside. Have to have a candle and have to have chocolate. Listen, I'm from the hood. I had a bottle of Boone's Farm wine. That's what I had. She said yes. That was the key. I married the most beautiful woman I'd ever seen in my life. Y'all ever been to a wedding, and even before the wedding starts, you hear this? How in the world? And it was coming from my side of the family. We get married. We have a few children. Our lives are great. One day, the lump in her left breast. Breast cancer. 6 years after that diagnosis, me and my little boy walked up. 2 years. If it wasn't for my faith in God, I wouldn't be sick. If it wasn't for those two little boys, there'd have been no reason to go on. I was completely lost. That was rock bottom. You know what sustained me? The wisdom of a third grade drummer. The wisdom of a simple book. We're at the Catholic. Never seen my dad cry. This time I saw my dad cry. That was his daughter, not his daughter-in-law. I'm right behind my father about the last birth. My father shared three words that changed. Would be the last lesson. He said, son, just stand. Keep standing. You keep standing, no matter how rough the sea, you and I'm not talking about water. Keep standing. No matter what, don't. Clearly, okay. He's looked me in the eye and said, it doesn't matter to me any longer. What matters to me most is how I live. I ask y'all one question. A question that I was asked all my life. How you live? How you live? Every day ask yourself that question. Here's what a book would suggest you to live this way. That you would not judge. That you would show up early. You'd be kind. You'd make sure that servant's huge in you. That if you're going to do something, you do it the right way. That cook would tell you this, that it's never wrong to do the right thing. That how you do anything is how you do everything. In that way, you will grow your in that way, you will honor all those who have gone before you, who have invested in you. Look in those unlikeliest places for wisdom. Enhance your life every day by seeking that wisdom and asking yourself every night. May God richly bless y'all. Thank you for having me.
Well, I want to congratulate all. Is that all walk path life, wait life. So that was to get to Lake State College, taking that walk. Always. And now that's quiet place a remember knowledge. I want everybody community of it. So
all of college. All right, are you guys ready? I will now call the names of the graduates that are in attendance. Would the graduating class please go to the aisle by Bridget? So when we call your name, you're going to come up a little step that will hand you your, will flip your task. And as you come down, you will receive money. Will Case. Is alphabetical. Christopher Bella. Jordan Burch. Hannah Brown. Sadie. Shaylee Charbonneau. Daylen Crow. Luke David. Chase Stock. Raydonna Feather. Haley Frederick. Cheyenne Fink. Christian Holland. Parker Halley. Courtney Laura. Blaze Miller. Scott Floyd the second. Emily Moore Rivera. Amanda Nelson. Marissa Newman. Austin Peltier. paid testing. Jonathan Sanchez. Michelle Spotted Horse. Malachi Sullivan. Miriam Sullivan. Michaela Trout. Rebecca Trout. Dolores Williams. Congratulations to each and every one of you, and best of luck with your future endeavors. From the entire staff here at Lake Region State College, we are all so very proud of you. Now for the Adult Learning Center Award. First, I would like to take this time to congratulate our very own Bridget Hanlon for well-deserved award. In September, Bridget was awarded the North Dakota Association for Lifelong Learning's Educator of the Year. Bridget takes the uniqueness of each student into account in preparing individualized and goals with differentiated instruction to accommodate. Her philosophy of having the student take one step at a time has continued to help students recognize their success, as well as help our adults reach and surpass our goals. Every day, she brings hope to the students who have failed in the past. Bridget, congratulations on being selected as Educator of the Year from all of us. Next, I would like to present this year's Devils Lake Adult Learning Center Student of the Year. The Student of the Year Award is an annual award designed to recognize outstanding students at the Devils Lake Adult Learning. This is an opportunity to identify students who have demonstrated excellent academic achievement while pursuing their diploma. Candidates receiving this award have proven themselves their record of service, dedication, and performance while in the classroom. Not only are these students maintaining success in the classroom, but they also balance many different aspects. This award is designed to recognize these students' hard work and accomplishments. Studying for 4 months without taking an official test passed. This student's determination to continue to come to class and focus on his studies made the difference. If he had not persevered and returned to school week after week, he would not have been able to complete his day after day. He continued to greet the instructors at the center with a smile and positive. He refused to complain and worked eagerly with the staff to create a learning plan that he could utilize to increase. The 2000 Student of the Year is Jordan Burt. One last note. I would like to leave you with a quote. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Good luck as you take your next step in the journey to a successful life. This concludes our ceremony for the evening. At this time, I would like to encourage everyone to stay and visit and enjoy a reception in the dining room. There will be a light meal served. Also, there are photo booth props available and picture opportunities with the graduation cake as well as door prizes. Congratulations again. Thank you for coming.